The Office of the Solicitor General and Justice Department dismayed with the International Criminal Court's decision to continue its probe on the Duterte drug war. In a 3-2 vote, the judges of the appeals chamber sided with the pretrial chamber's ruling last January, particularly with respect to the issue of jurisdiction. The Philippine government had insisted the country had withdrawn from the ICC by the time the probe started. The OSG says the ruling failed to recognize the sovereign rights of the Philippines to conduct its own investigations into the bloody war on drugs.
The majority decision does not alter the fact that the Republic, through its various national and local agencies, remains fully committed to the internal investigation and prosecution of allegations connected to the anti-illegal drug campaign. The Philippine government will not be deterred by today's outcome. The chamber's majority conveniently brushed this aside. And worse, they refused to consider the Philippines' jurisdictional challenge on the ground that the impugned decision of the pre-trial chamber is not a decision on jurisdiction.
And just a few minutes ago, Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla held a briefing where he insisted the ICC should not interfere in the affairs of the country. And as for former President Rodrigo Duterte, his former spokesperson said Duterte isn't bothered by the ruling.
Well, the former president could not care less. No, they could make any decision they want, but he has said from the very beginning that he will never recognize jurisdiction of a foreign court and he will never appear before foreign judges. Victims of alleged crimes committed in the territory of the Philippines, because we are a sovereign and independent state, should file their cases here in the Philippines, and he would face them anytime, anywhere, but before Philippine courts. We are counting on the statement of PBBM that he will never cooperate with the court, and unfortunately, the ICC does not have its own police force that will serve its warrants for arrest.
More than 6,000 people have been killed in the drug war, according to police data, but rights groups say the real toll is much higher. The ICC's decision drawing mixed reactions here at home. Senator Riza Ontiveros welcomes the continuation of the drug war probe. She says it is an important step in attaining justice for families and victims of extrajudicial killings. For National Union of People's Lawyers President Nery Colmenares, he is optimistic that the ICC can serve warrants against those behind the bloody drug war.
Nagtaka ako dyan sa mga sinasabi palagi ng gobyerno na hindi kami magko-cooperate, hindi papasokin dito ang investigator. Na parang kailangan ba ng piskal na pumunta sa lugar kung saan nangyari ang krimen para mag-imbestiga? Hindi ako masyadong nadi-disheartened dyan sa mga nagsasabing, alang mangyayari dyan, wala naman kasing police yung ICC. Maraming instance na naipatupad ng ICC yung warrant of arrest kahit wala silang police. Malaking tagumpay na pinayagan ng korte ang investigasyon.
Philippine Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, meanwhile, sees no need for the ICC's intervention.
Kung pumayag tayo, parang sinasabi natin, failed state tayo, na hindi gumagana ang sistema ng ating bansa, na ang ating korte ay hindi gumagana. At lahat naman tayo sang-ayon na ang gobyerno natin, ang ating sistema ng hustisya ay gumagana. At hindi tayo tinatawag na failed state katulad ng ibang bansa na nagkakaroon ng civil war at magulo. No, dito sa atin ay gumagana ang sistema natin. Kaya hindi ko nakikita yung punto na dapat isurrender, ibigay pa natin yung pag-iimbestiga sa ibang lahi dahil parang inaamin na natin na ano tayo, isa tayong failed state.
A human rights lawyer, meanwhile, calls on the families of drug war victims to manage their expectations in the ICC's probe. Attorney Ruben Carranza says while the ICC's decision to continue its probe on the Duterte administration's drug war is a win in itself, the process will be a long one. He adds the refusal of the Marcos administration to cooperate will also complicate the case.
The Philippine government will continue the strategy of obstructing justice while spreading disinformation about this case. It will continue to obstruct by claiming that the ICC has no jurisdiction despite the fact that the Philippine government has participated in the litigation so far. Politics in the Philippines could change the dynamics of the ICC as it has changed the dynamics of other cases in other countries where incumbent presidents or new administrations have decided to cooperate with the ICC or not decided to cooperate with the ICC. So a lot of what happens at the International Criminal Court depends on what might happen politically in Manila.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. speaks up on the visit of his predecessor to China. Marcos says he is aware of former President Duterte's trip to Beijing. He adds he welcomes any line of communication to China that would help ease tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
Alam ko naman ang pupunta siya. At magkaibigan sila, magkakilala sila. So I hope that napag-usapan nila yung mga issue na ngayon na mga nakikita natin, yung mga shadowing, yung mga kung ano-ano, all of these things that we are seeing now, I hope na napag-usapan nila para naman magkaroon tayo ng progress. Kasi yun naman talagang habol natin, patuloy ang pag-uusap. Kaya I welcome any new lines of communication. If that is President PRRD, then good. Hindi importante sa akin kung sino, kung ano, basta may makausap sila, baka makatulong eh. So I hope, I am sure that that he will have a hindi naman report, but I'm sure he will be able to tell us what happened during the conversation.
Well, the Philippine Foreign Affairs Department meanwhile says it has no official information on Duterte's trip to China. Former presidential spokesperson Harry Roque said it was a personal visit for Duterte.
I was told that the meeting, as we saw on TV, was really a personal and almost a one-on-one meeting between the president and President Xi.
Philippine Senator Ronald De La Rosa says there is no connection between the China trip of former President Duterte and the ICC's decision to continue its drug war probe. See, there have been speculations Duterte may be seeking a deal with China should the ICC investigation lead to an arrest warrant against him. China is not a member of the ICC.
Nagkakatao lang yun na wala lang. Nagkakatao lang talaga na pumunta siya doon. I'm not sure kung inibitahan siya. Inibitahan ba siya or what. Basta nagkakatao lang yung biyahe niya. Andito po kami. Hindi po kami magtatago. Wala po kaming kinatakutan. Alam namin walang pupuntahan rin yung investigasyon na yan.
Senator De La Rosa, meanwhile, reveals he will seek re-election in the 2025 midterm polls. The chief architect of the Duterte drug war also confident the ICC probe won't negatively affect his bid.
Ang magkukumbuto, yung sumusuporta ng Pangulong Duterte. O ba, the more nalalaki yung suporta natin dahil nga marami na rin Pilipino nagagalit sa pakikialam nila dito sa ating soberenya. Baka positively pa magiging impact nito sa aking planong pagtakbo sa aking re-election bid. And we will be running for our re-election. Kami tatlo ni Senator Bongo at Senator Francis Tolentino.